one of the most important topics in aeronautics, that is working length determination. Working length determination is very important from your clinical and theory point of view. We'll be discussing introduction, followed by definition, anatomy of the apex in brief, followed by significance of working length, and what are the methods of working length determination, and we have radiographic and non-radiographic methods under determination methods. Finally, we have working width determination. Today, we'll be discussing about the first few sessions of this topic. Coming to introduction, accurate working length is the key to success in aeronautics. Cleaning, shaping and obturation cannot be accurately accomplished unless we have a correct working length. Incorrect measurements in working length, that is either over or under measurements, can result in various procedural errors. This will affect the treatment result, the end result of the treatment. That is, it can result in failure of RCP. Working length can be measured using various radiographic and non-radiographic methods. Coming to the definition of working length determination. According to 7th edition of Glossary of Aeronautic Terms, working length is defined as the distance from a cardinal reference point to the point at which the canal preparation and obturation should terminate. That is, it's the distance from reference point to the apical constriction. This length is called the working length of a canal. That is, the length from reference point to the apical constriction is the area where we have to clean, shape and obturate. Next is reference point. So what is reference point? It is the site on the occlusal or incisal surface from which the measurements are being made. So it can be either the incisal edge for the anterior teeth or the buccal cusp tip for a molar teeth. And the reference point should be stable throughout the canal preparation and obturation. If the reference point is not stable, this might lead to errors in the working length and this can ultimately affect your obturation, cleaning, shaping and obturation. Before we go into the details of working length determination, let's discuss in brief about the anatomy of foot apex. First is anatomic apex. So what is anatomic apex? It is the tip or end of the root determined morphologically. Whereas radiographic apex is the tip or end of the root determined radiographically. As you can see in the radiograph, this is the tip or the apex as seen in the radiograph. So this is the radiographic apex of the skin. Next is apical foramen. So what is apical foramen? Apical foramen is the main opening of the canal. So it can be either short or away from the anatomic or the radiographic apex. Next is apical constriction or the minor diameter. So what is apical constriction or minor diameter? It is the apical portion of the root canal having the narrowest diameter. As you can see in the diagram, point A is the narrowest portion of this canal and this region is called the apical constriction or the minor diameter. So our measurement should be from the reference point to the minor diameter, that is up till the point A. And in this figure, figure B is the major diameter for the apical foramen and A is the point A is the minor diameter. So the apical apical constriction can be either 0.5 to 1 mm short of the apical foramen. Now coming to Dummer's classification. According to the topography of the apical constriction, Dummer has classified it into four major types. It can be either traditional single constriction, or it can be a tapering constriction, or multi-constricted, or a parallel constriction. These are the four main types of apical constriction according to Dummer. Next is major and minor diameter. According to Cutler, the distance between the major and minor diameter varies between various age groups. That is, between 18 to 25 years, the distance between the major and minor diameter will be around 0.5 to 4, and in older age group, that is above 55 years, it will be in the range of 0.659. Now, what is morning glory appearance? As you can see in this diagram, the canal widens from point A to B, and this space between A and B can be compared to that of a funnel shape or hyperbolic or a shape of a morning glory. So, from the epical constrictor, the canal widens as it approaches the epical foramen from point A to point B. And the space between these two areas is described as morning glory appearance. Next is cemento-dentinal junction. So what is cemento-dentinal junction? It's a junction between cementum and dentin. And cemento-dentinal junction should not always coincide with the epical constriction. It might be 0.5 to 3 and 0.3 mm short of the anatomic apex. Next is accessory foramen. So the main canal exits through the major foramen, whereas the lateral canals, they exit through the accessory foramen into the periapical area. These are the lateral canals. As you can see in the diagram, this is the lateral canal, and this lateral canals, they exit through the accessory foramen into the periapical area. And now what is epical delta? It is the branching pattern of the accessory canals and the minor foramen, which is seen at the tip of the root. So that's all about the anatomical features of the root apex. Now we will be discussing about the significance of working length. So what is the significance? What's the importance of working length? Working length, it determines how far into the canal the instrument should be placed and work. That is, how deep into the canal we can remove the tissue debris and toxic metabolites. Then it limits the depth to which the canal filling must be placed, that is the epical limit of cleaning, shaking and filling. It affects the degree of pain and discomfort the patient will feel after the appointment. That is, if you are going beyond the working length, what will happen? You are pricking your PDL. That can result in post-operative pain for the patient. So it will affect the degree of pain and discomfort following the visit. That is, if you are working at apex or short of apex, the patient will not have much of post-operative discomfort than when you are going beyond the actual working length. Next is, if calculated within correct minutes, it play a very important role in determining the success of your root canal treatment. Conversely, if calculated incorrectly, it results in treatment failure. So, if you are strictly following your working length, hold throughout the procedure, that is, throughout your heat, shaking and going to length too long, that is if you are going beyond your apex, that is if you have gone much beyond the working length, what will happen? You are perforating your apical constriction, that is you are going beyond your apical constriction. This can result in overfilling or overextension of your gutta percha. Increase post-operative pain. There will be post-operative, severe post-operative discomfort for the patient as you have gone beyond the apex and you have irritated your PDA. Blunt healing and lower success rate owing to incomplete generation of the cementum, PDA and annular bone.